next live cable show in the San Gabriel Valley. Live from the City of Industry, it's Marty's Corner. Join Marty and his guest, Joel Goodwin, Eagle Scout from Sierra Madre. The fabulous comedian, Charlie Marco. Craig Moore, the Celtic Band, and Bob Sprigg from Pets Delight. It's Saturday night, it's 9:30. I'm Leanne. It's time to party with our host. Here's Marty!
Everybody, and welcome to Marty's Corner, coming to you live from Channel 32 in the City of Industry for a Saturday night, 9:30. How are y'all doing tonight? You having a good time so far?
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, we're so glad all of you here are in the audience watching our show live, and all of you at home that are watching us. We know it's a Saturday night, it's 9:30, and there's other things you'd rather be doing on a Saturday night, maybe at 9:30. Whatever you're doing now, stop what you're doing, wash yourself up, and come watch the show, huh, please?
Yeah.
Please! Now, you could go to the movies if you want to. A couple of good movies are out. Of course, you have James and the Giant Peach.
Yeah.
But I know you'd rather be here and watch Marty and his Giant Lemon, huh? No? No, it's been a while since we've been here. It's been about, what, 6 months? No, it's been about 6 weeks since we've joined you on Marty's Corner. And what's been going on in the news since we joined you last? The famed guitarist of the Grateful Dead, Jerry Garcia, had his ashes, I guess, thrown out amongst the San Francisco Bay. You see that kind of, you know, in the bay, kind of a nice memorial for Jerry. And I guess it wasn't his first choice. The first choice, of course, was the Dead Sea. Dead Sea. And apparently observers who saw the ceremony said some of the fish in the harbor were swimming upside down and eating a lot of Twinkies. So, you get that one? Nobody liked that one. In the news, Madonna's pregnant! Madonna's pregnant! They don't know whose it is. I'm sure she knows who the father is. And apparently the child, whoever he is or her, that come out have to wear glasses so they don't get poked with those pointy cones, she always says. Pointy cones? No? Oh. You have any sports fans in the crowd? Sports fans, anybody?
Yay!
How about those Lakers, huh? Those fighting Lakers, huh?
Yeah.
Just recently in the news, of course, Magic Johnson and Nick Van Exel have been suspended by the NBA for some bumping and shoving and pushing around. And then you have in the fight game Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson's in trouble again. He got some girl in Chicago that's accusing him of sexual assault. Poor Mike. He just can't stay out of those clinches long enough, I guess. Poor guy. Remember the good old days? Remember the good old days when fighters used to hit people and basketball players tried to score? Remember those good old days, huh? Up in Montana, they finally, what they think is the Unabomber has been arrested up in Montana. Ted Kaczynski, is that his name? Big
yes.
Ted?
Yes.
The former professor of math, I guess, at Berkeley, Michigan. Incredible mind, but he's out doing these crazy things. And they found his cabin, right? His 10 by 12 foot cabin way in the mountains. Took the FBI 2 weeks to gather evidence. 2 weeks! That's a government job for you, huh? 2 weeks! 10 by 12 foot cabin. They found some very interesting things, I guess, in Ted's little cabin there. I guess they found some antidepressant drugs, and they're really glad he was on his antidepressant drug, because if he wasn't, he would have done something real crazy, you know? That's, oh, okay. And I guess Ted's brother David turned him in. Did you see that?
Yeah.
David?
Yes.
David turned him in? Now, if I was David, I would not be opening up any Christmas cards from Ted this year. No, no.
No packages.
Now, Ted had one of his demands I guess, was met. They actually published his 35,000-word manifesto in a couple of newspapers in the country. 35,000. And the thing was rambling and disconnected. And it just goes to show you, if you wait till Sunday night to do a paper, it never comes out right, huh?
Hey, Marty, did you write your monologue, too?
Yes, I did. But actually, my monologue was found in some of the bombs in his shack. Just kidding. Also, the brothers Eric and Lyle Menendez have been sentenced, I guess, for the killing of their parents, right?
Yeah.
Right? Eric and Lyle. About time, huh? And apparently their sentence was life in prison without the possibility of a book deal. That was a good joke. That was like the best joke we had. I guess the people in Riverside County are trying to get their cities back in shape. They're taking video cameras out into the areas where drug trafficking is going on, people that inhabit these areas. And I guess they go out through the cameras and they film the drug dealers. And I guess the drug dealers are running for cover. The funny thing is, so is the Riverside County Police Department. Running for cover. We have a good show for you here at Marty's Corner, coming to you live from PCI. We have a gentleman on who's a Boy Scout from Sierra Madre, and he did one of the most incredible Eagle Scout projects that I've ever heard of, and he'll be on talking about the project he did up in Sierra Madre for the city of Sierra Madre. Joel Goodwin is here tonight.
Yeah,
Joel Goodwin! A comedian joins us from the Ice House in Pasadena. He's the MC at the Ice House, and he'll be making his first appearance here on Marty's Corner. Charlie Marco is here tonight. Charlie Marco is here. Charlie. We have a gentleman who's bringing down his goat. A man and his goat are here. A man and his goat. Bob and Priscilla are here tonight. Bob and Priscilla. We have a Irish folk band here. Woo. Guys who wear dresses are going to be here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Crackmore is here. Crackmore is here.
Yeah.
Try something new on the corner. We're going to be doing our first phone quiz, actually calling people up in the TV audience and harassing them and bugging them on a Saturday night, the phone quiz. And, of course, the top nine list, which is not going to be here. I'm sorry, where did that come from?
Oh,
the band, I know. Well, maybe next month. I know you're all, like, waiting for that. But we have a good show for you. Please don't go away. Guys, could you please get us out of here?
Are you looking for somewhere to shop?
I shop La Fuente.
I shop La Fuente.
I shop in La Fuente.
The next time you need a product or service, support your local businesses. Shop La Fuente. You'll be glad you did.
Marty's Corner, the corner band one time. Yay! Frank just remarked we need a bigger studio. These guys are like shoved in the corner tonight, but they're doing a good job. Doing a good job anyhow. Welcome back. It with me as always is my co-host Leanne. How you doing, Leanne?
Wonderful. And we have a wonderful, huge audience. Let's hear it.
Yay! Yay!
We'll see how much they're clapping at the end of the show,
okay.
Right? Now, we've been on the air for about 3 years, and we're going to try something different here on Marty's Corner.
Yes,
kind of a new kind of angle here. We're going to actually be calling up people at home live right now on the air, and we're going to go ahead and go with the first phone quiz. Phone quiz on Marty's Corner. Maybe a little phone quiz music maybe here? What's that? Phone quit music from Marty's Corner. We're going to go ahead and call some people up. Why don't you go and give me a number here, Leanne? Now, we have some incredible gifts to give away. Why don't you go and show the gifts real quick?
Okay.
The gift, singular.
Fabulous
t-shirt.
Show the other side.
Show the other side.
Oh.
Yay. Hulk Hogan. Woo.
And you can win that tonight on phone quiz, okay? And the phone quiz tonight is gonna be Name the Crew. Name the Crew on Marty's Corner, and we'll show you how that works a little bit later. Let's go ahead and make a couple phone calls here, see if anybody will talk to me on a live Friday night. All right, what do we got here, Saturday night? What do we got?
336.
Okay, here we go.
1408.
Start that again.
336.
Okay, what else?
Yeah.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Please keep it down. I'm bothering somebody on a Saturday night. They're sleeping. They're insomniacs, and they're going to... We have three... Hello, this is Marty Shields from Marty's Corner talking to you live from TCI Cablevision. Who am I speaking with? She told me good night. Okay! Let's try one more time. Let's call another unsuspecting person.
333-6045.
All right, we have another person here in the area. Let's see if they'll talk to me on a Saturday night. Be a little more nicer than the last bit. Oh, it's their machine. I'm sorry. Let's try one more time. Okay.
What a great
trick. Yeah, here we go.
This is going so well.
Here we go. If we get somebody, it's going to be a great bit.
Marty, why not?
I know, I really should call you mom. Here we go. Third time's a charm. And we have one ring. Two rings. Three rings.
Three
rings. Who thought of this bit? Who thought of this bit?
I think that was you, Marty.
The premise
Danny
was.
Thought about this bit.
The premise was good.
And he's gone.
But as you can tell.
Hey, Marty, call my mom.
Can we try one more?
There's nobody. Read what? What's?
Call my mom.
Okay.
Plan.
Why don't you go and dial the number? Frank's mom, we're calling you right now. Pick up, please.
Save our bit.
It's Francis, correct? What's your mom's name?
Phyllis.
This is Marty from Marty's Corner. How you doing?
We're online.
Okay, well, can we put your voice on the phone, please, over the air? Okay, here we go. This is Frank's mom. How you doing tonight?
I'm doing fine.
Can we get some audio here in the, okay. And now you're watching the show from where? Where do you live?
Right, my house. I'm watching it from my house, but I haven't seen the corner band yet.
You haven't seen the corner band yet? You haven't seen Frank yet? We get a shot of Frank over here real quick, the corner band. She's not going to talk to us until we get a shot of her kid. Say hi, Mom, Frank. Phyllis, thank you so much. We like to have you help us out on this bit that's going nowhere. Would you like to win this Hulk Hogan t-shirt right here?
Yeah, but I think he's taking it away from me.
I think it's Frankie's size, brother. It's a great one. What we'd like you to do, Phyllis, we're going to give you a shot of somebody on the crew here. And we want you to name them. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Want you to get a shot of somebody? Okay, can you see your TV screen?
Yeah.
Who is that, Phyllis?
Crazy Mike!
Crazy Mike! Yeah! Yeah! Phyllis, thank you so much. We appreciate you talking to us. And wait, Frank wants to say something to you.
Mom, can you have those shirts done by Monday? Thanks, Mom. I love you.
Okay. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the show. Good night.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Oh. Winner, winner, winner. Okay. Are we going to make any more phone calls? I mean, we did such well in those first three. No, we're not. Okay. We're going to go ahead and continue with the show. We have a guest here in Marty's Corner. He's a young man from Sierra Madre. And we just found out about this gentleman about 2 months ago, I guess. He's an Eagle Scout. And his project to earn his Eagle badge was pretty incredible. Can you please give a warm welcome to Joel Goodwin and his good friend, Rich Snyder. Come on out. There we go. Come on. Hey. Joel, how you doing? Leanne, I have a seat over here. Have a seat over here, Joel. We're going to hook you up. Okay. Have a seat right there. Have a seat right here, Joel. Okay, there we go. And Rich, why don't you just call right next to him there?
Okay.
Professional, ladies and gentlemen. Professional. Okay, see the. Thank you, Leanne. Are we all hooked up?
I must.
We're almost going to get Rich hooked up.
I'm sorry, Martin said he was an Eagle Snack.
No, not an Eagle Snack. An Eagle Scout. Are we ready to go on this?
Yep.
Okay. How you doing, Joel?
Great.
You having a good time so far?
Oh, yes.
Tell us a little bit about your project that you did up in Sierra Madre, Joel.
Well, this is something I thought of during my working on my Eagle Scout. I was on my bike one day going for Sierra Madre, actually coming home on my bike on my way home from school, and I was taking a look at some of the fire hydrants in the city and thought, wow, these need work. So I thought, well, why not try something different? I don't think anybody's ever thought of this, so I decided to get a crew of my guys together from my scout troop, and we went out and inventoried the fire hydrants, and then we discovered we needed to replace, we had to paint 160 of the hydrants, we had to replace 249 blue dots, we had 145 non-accessible hydrants, and six of them were leaking water. Those were all taken care of by the city, but the only thing we did was paint the hydrants and replace the caps.
How long did it take you, Joel?
It took me two Saturdays.
Two Saturdays?
Wow.
To do both projects.
That's incredible. I mean, yeah. Next to you is Rich Schneider. Rich, what's your title up in Sierra Madre, Rich?
I'm the fire marshal for the city.
Tell us about Joel and his project.
Well, Joel came to me with a project, a special project to paint the fire hydrants.
Right.
And it was an Eagle Scout project, and I know that Eagle Scout projects are a little bit bigger than just painting a fire hydrant. So we sat down together and decided to come up with this program where he surveyed every fire hydrant in the entire city. And he told us the exact location of every fire hydrant by address, the leaking, the accessibility, the painting, the whole thing. He put 20 of his friends together, did the entire survey, saving the fire department countless hours. I have a department with two people, and it would be impossible to try to put something like that together.
What's this done for the city?
Well, we have obviously identified all the fire hydrants that were in need of repair. I was surprised to find that only six of them leaked. We did find 23 hydrants that were missing caps and quite a few blue dots that are markers in the middle of the street that the firemen use when we're responding to an emergency.
Right.
That's how we pick the fire hydrant for the fire. So it helped out the fire department and the city water department and gave us a good inventory of what the infrastructure of the city is at right now with fire hydrants.
You also won a special award, I guess, at the city hall. Is that right? You want, let's show that up real quick. This thing weighs a ton.
Actually, I won this. Yeah. Actually, I won this award. That after we finished all the painting of the hydrants, we had a special luncheon that Richard provided, all the pizza for everybody, and I was given this award from the fire department, and I think it's really great. And I just felt it's something I had to do for the city to make Sierra Madre a safer and better city for the fire department to work around.
That's incredible. I'm sorry.
That's so cool.
Tell us a little about the fire department. You're a volunteer fire department in Sierra Madre.
Yeah, Sierra Madre is the only all-volunteer fire department in Los Angeles County.
So what's that mean exactly?
None of the people in the fire department are paid.
Not even you?
Well, I'm with fire prevention.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I've been with the fire department for 10 years as an engineer. And for the past 5 years, I was hired by the city as the fire marshal. Actually, fire inspector, and worked my way up to fire marshal. So that's my career is fire prevention.
Joel, we're so glad you came down the show. And congratulations again on not only your Eagle badge, but also this great award from the city of Sierra Madre. Here, one more time for Joel Goodwin, Rich Schneider.
All right, good job, Joel.
Stay right here. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back, guys. Get us out of here. Yeah.
Frankie Briggy.
It's got to be Sabado Gigante, Marty.
Wrong, Leanne.
Huellhauser, California Gold.
Wrong. Marty's Corner, TCI Cablevision. Question number two. Who's the best host in San Gabriel Valley? Frankie Riggy.
It's Carney, Marty.
Wrong, man.
Chevy Chase.
Wrong. Marty Shields, TCI Cablevision, Marty's Corner. Back live on a Saturday night at Marty's Corner. We have a gentleman in Marty's Corner. He's been making his first appearance on Marty's Corner. He's a MC, also a very, very funny stand-up comedian at the Ice House up in Pasadena. Can you please give a warm welcome to Charlie Marco. Charlie!
Hey, folks, keep it going for Marty. Come on, keep it going for Marty. He's doing a great job.
Thank you, Charlie.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway, good to be here. Almost didn't make it. Got a call this afternoon from my agent. They had a last-minute thing. They wanted to fly me out to Hawaii, all expenses paid, to host one of those Hawaiian Tropic bikini contests. I said, hey, are you kidding? I got 15 people waiting for me at a cable station in West Covina. Man, there's no place I'd rather be. Man. So it's going to be a goat and a Boy Scout. I'm there, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm there. The guys in kilts, too, right? Here we're on, Channel 32, which is between, C-SPAN 2 and the Armenian Home Shopping Network, I believe. And, anyway, I'm glad I stayed in town. Beautiful day today, wasn't it? Wasn't it beautiful? Oh, man. The sun was shining, the birds were singing, even the tigers were using, bright spring colors. You know what I'm saying? It's just a beautiful thing it was. Anyway, can you believe April's almost over? Think what we got coming up, okay? In less than a year, a new presidential election. Then in 4 years, the year 2000. Then in only 15 years, I'll have good credit. So I'm pretty excited about that, too. Dude, it's okay to have bad credit. Everybody has bad credit. Now, think about it. The government is over its credit limit. I mean, think about it. That means if Clinton were signing the Declaration of Independence, he'd need a co-signer. Anyway, you guys excited about the election, are you? It's going to be what, Clinton versus Dole, pretty much a Jed Clampett versus Grandpa Munster kind of scenario. You know what I'm saying? It's scary stuff, though, man. A lot going on right now. Now, Marty was talking about the Unabomber. Do you think that guy is the Unabomber or not? Do you think he is?
Yeah.
Oh, man, you're all the evidence they found. They found the bomb. They found the typewriter. Then in the little room behind the cabin, Cato Kaelin.
And he was there.
He was the Uniloafer. Cato Kaelin was the Uniloafer, man. He was there. Anyway. Montana, anybody from Montana or not? That is a crazy state, isn't it? The Freeman, man. What they're doing, they want to destroy the government. They're bouncing checks for millions of dollars. They don't belong in jail. They belong in Congress. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, man, things are going pretty well, though. Things are going pretty well. Got the air raid siren going off over there. But that's good. It's my cue to get off. But anyway, things are going well. I see a lot of movies. Just saw the movie Toy Story. Have you guys seen that? I finally saw it. Isn't that a great movie?
Yeah!
I mean, it's not just a great movie. The neat thing is, I mean, it's all done in computers. It looks real, but everything's artificial. Everything's fake. Kind of like Baywatch. You know what I'm saying? Baywatch fans, yeah. I love going to movies. So I love movies. That's why I don't read. Because I mean, think about it. Doesn't it seem like every time you go to the movies with somebody that reads, they always say the same thing. What do they say? The book was better, right? Now, you see, this is why I will never date any woman who has read that book, The Joy of Sex. I would never say, hey, you know, Charlie, last night was okay, but the book was better. I mean, I don't hear that. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, go back to the phones, Marty. Let's do it. No, just kidding. Things are going well, though. I love comedy, and just turned 33 recently, so I'm thinking about investing. So I went to a stockbroker to see which investment would be right for someone with my income, and he suggested Super Lotto. So, hey, not just Lotto, Super Lotto, see? First thing I do, though, if I'm in the lottery, I'd buy a really expensive car, like a Ferrari. Wouldn't it be cool to have a Ferrari? See, if I had a car that expensive, though, every time I parked it, I'd leave the headlights on. So that way I'd be in the health club working out next to some really hot babe and you'd hear, with the owner of a red Ferrari. I go, that must be mine. I drive a cool car too. Currently I drive a white Vette. Yeah, it's a 1975 Chevette, which makes it sort of a classic. Oh, yeah. Got all the options like AM, FM, 8-track, just a chick magnet, you know what I'm saying? Couldn't afford LoJack, so I got Kojak. If you try to steal it, it goes, who loves you, baby? Who loves you, baby? Who loves you, baby? Crazy Mike like that, Jack. I like that. Give it to Mikey. He'll like anything, man. He will. Anyway, thank you, Mike. That's not actually funny. When's the goat coming out? Anyway, but anyway, But yeah, I love doing this job. This is a fun thing. And you meet a lot of women. I met a woman when I was in Hawaii. We've been doing the long-distance relationship, the whole thing. It's expensive, though. Big phone bills. Like, she lives in the 808 area code. My last girlfriend lived in the 1-900 area code. Oh, man. You talk about a phone. What is that, Mike? Like, $3.95 a minute? Something like that? And Mike knows. You know that? Remember the good old days when some pervert would just call you at random and start talking dirty for free? Do you remember that? It was a simpler time, a happier time. But I love first dates, though, because to me, a first date is like a seed. And you know, folks, that seed might just someday blossom into the beautiful flower of a relationship. Do you like that? Yeah, I read that in Hustler. Yeah. Anyway, that's my time. You guys, been a lot of fun. I'm going to go talk to Marty. I'll see you guys later.
Charlie, how you doing? Thank you so much.
Okay,
come on up. You sure this is Leanne and Charlie?
Hey,
we'll see right over here, Charlie.
Okay.
Oh, we're going to do the official hooking up the guests. Charlie's got it down. Geez, he's ready to go.
Yeah, there we go. Okay.
Charlie Marco.
Yeah.
Is that a stage name?
No, it's my real name.
Charlie's
actually.
Real name? Yeah. Okay. You're an MC down at the Ice House.
Down at the Ice House? Been doing that for about 5 years.
What's going down at the Ice House these days?
Oh, we got Bill Maher's going to be there tomorrow night
from
Comedy Central. Do you guys know about that?
Yeah.
The Ice House is the oldest comedy club in LA, probably the oldest in the country. Been doing it since 1960.
Wow.
So the amazing thing is, you know, people like Steve Martin, Lily Tomlin, all these people, they started out there, they went on to bigger and better things, but don't you worry, folks, because I am not going anywhere. I
mean, I'm right here.
Right here, man. I'm here forever.
What kind of gigs you got coming up?
Actually, I'm pretty excited. I just found out I got my own game show, Marty, so I'm really happy
about
that. Yeah, it's on Channel 18, the Korean channel.
Oh, okay,
good.
As soon as I learn Korean, man, we're going to be a lot more stuff away, Marty.
There's little things in life you gotta learn.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Do you have a phone number if someone wants to actually get a hold of you to do an event or a gig? What's your number, Charlie?
Oh, sure, we can flash it. It's my home phone. It's 818-846-0429.
We're gonna call you a little bit later if you don't mind.
Oh, jeez. I gave out my home phone number. They're writing it down. That's good. Good deal.
Okay, thank you so much. Can you stay around? We have a goat coming on.
Sure, I've worked with goats before.
Have you really?
I have actually. Yeah.
We have a gentleman here to Marty's Corner who's an owner of a pet store up in Monrovia and Covina. He's got a bunch of pet stores. He'll be bringing on one of his prized animals down at the pet store, Bob and his friend Priscilla. Come on out, Bob! Yeah. Priscilla! Why don't you go on up here and take this off and just move. Whoa, there we go. We're going to move down. Move on down here. Wait, come on in here.
Deal. Have a seat.
Have a seat, Bob. Oh, look out! We're going back again. We're off kilter here. Can we get over there?
Is it?
Yes, it's that. Why are you going to pull
off the brick? I think.
It's off the back. There you go.
We don't bar any expense. Have a seat here.
Goat
needs a mic.
Does he really? Okay, we're gonna go and hook you up here if we could real quick.
You want me to hook the goat up?
No.
Do you want this in right here?
Oh, Bob, how you doing?
Real good.
And this is Priscilla.
This is Priscilla.
Tell us about Priscilla.
Well, she's about a year and 4 months old. She's a little dwarf pygmy goat. I've had her since she's about 4 days old. She's a good little pet, good little companion. She's real clean. She's quiet for now.
Can we get a shot of her on camera? Can you turn her face around so we get a shot of her somewhere? One of these guys get a shot of her face.
Aww. Oh, Priscilla.
Here, babe.
Now, goats are becoming more popular as pets these days.
Yeah. Quite a few people are getting into goats and pigs and... If you give these little guys a chance, you'll find out to make a really good domestic pet.
Now, don't you have to be zoned in a certain area to have a goat, a pygmy goat?
Most of the time you do. It usually falls into a size of property, as far as how far from somebody's house, horse property, farmland. But as long as you keep it quiet
in the
house.
What's the big problem about having a pig or a goat? I mean, what's the big hubbub about having one?
Probably being an inconvenience to somebody, like a neighbor. If you had a neighbor that watched.
Is she loud?
She doesn't make any noise.
So,
that's it.
So you said they're loud, though, I mean.
Well, in case you had 10 or 15 in the backyard, you would become maybe a nuisance to your next neighbor.
Uh-huh. If you have a herd.
Right.
You have a herd?
Exactly. Right.
But what do these things eat? Everything? Do goats eat everything?
What should they eat or what do they eat?
Well, either one. Go ahead and...
Use the alfalfa pellets. You can get a little bit of vegetables, a little bit of grain. But they'll nibble on about anything.
Does she mind being out here with all the lights and the cameras? She seems pretty sedate.
It's pretty lax.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Do they eat tin cans and stuff like that, like you always see in the cartoons, or not? Do they do that?
They just kind of chew on them a little.
Uh-huh. Just nibble a little bit?
Yeah.
You besides having goats down at your pet store, what other kind of animals do you have down there?
Well, we have little miniature potbelly pigs. We breed those. We do all types of reptiles. We have fish, we have birds, cats, dogs, just about everything.
Now, potbelly pigs, now they get real big. I mean, I've seen some that are larger than others. I mean, is there a variety in sizes? Or
well,
is there a standard size for pigs?
We have a real small breed. It's called a Silver Juliana.
Uh-huh.
And I have some friends that breed me. They have ranches. And they can stay anywhere between 20 and 50 pounds if you feed them right and if you neuter spay them at a young age. But if you keep and breed them, they usually get a little larger.
Do these things have, you take them down and get shots like a dog and all
yeah.
that?
Yeah, once a year they have a vaccine.
I mean, they're not going to develop anything like mad pygmy goat disease or nothing like that, will they?
Actually, they're pretty clean.
Are they really?
On a farm, they can get lice or they can get mites, but as a house pet, they're pretty clean.
Are they good with kids?
Real good. Real good. You
know, button them and stuff like that and smash them.
They have a tendency to push them around a little, but that's all right.
Can you?
Yeah, good. Pretty soft, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
What do you think?
It's the most action I've had in a lot of time.
Actually, you're petting my best friend.
Oh, really?
You
know, yeah. Okay.
Be careful.
That's like, it's very soft, it is. Yeah.
Can you train her to be a watch pygmy goat?
She usually lets you know something's around.
Does she?
Yeah.
Now, you said she talks to you.
Yeah, you
Come on, Bob, she doesn't talk to you.
Well, not all the time, only late at night.
Oh, okay. Oh. Yeah. I've heard that
no,
before.
She talks to me. She'll be in a store sound asleep. She's a little bottle baby. I've hand fed her since she's 4 days old. And the difference between a regular goat that feeds mama and a bottle baby is they're always a little whiner. She'll eat out of a bottle now. She'll down a big bottle of milk that quick. If she sees a bottle or you look over and go, babe, she'll wake up right away and go, meh, meh.
Now, you ever have her out in public? Does she go after little big kids with bottles and stuff? I mean, just a bottle.
She would. She would. If they wave that little bottle around, that's it.
That's it?
Yeah.
You want to give your number real quick to your
sure.
What's the name of your place? I'm sorry.
Pets Delight.
And tell me different locations.
We have one, a store in Monrovia, a store right. in South Pasadena. We have a store in Laguna Niguel and a store in Covina.
How long have you been doing this?
I've been in about 5 years.
What's your number down there real quick?
My number is 818-303-6505.
Well, Priscilla, it's been a pleasure to have you, sweetheart. Mm-hmm. Oh, what a pretty, pretty girl.
We could work as a team, too. I'll work with the guy.
I think she likes you.
I think so.
I think you're in. All
right. We'll set you up after the show, Charlie. Bob, thank you so much, Priscilla. Can we hear for Bob and Priscilla one time? Yeah. 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 We're going for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Gentlemen, could you please? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to Jack here, back on a live Saturday night. We have a bunch of guys in skirts here tonight. No, actually, we have a very, very interesting band that joins us. We saw these gentlemen up at the Wisteria Fete up in Sierra Madre about 2-3 weeks ago, and I talked to them on the street corner, and I talked them into coming down on the show, actually. I lied to them. They'll be doing their own brand of Irish Celtic music. Can you please give a warm welcome to Crackmore? Crackmore, ladies and gentlemen!
Dealing with the women. For many is the wise man, thus speak the rain.
John, how you doing?
Thank you, Marty.
Can we get right in here?
Sure.
Why don't you go talk in that microphone so they can hear you? John McAdams and Crackmore. Could you found a smaller banner by any chance, John?
I like the big one.
Bro. I can tell that.
I like the big one.
Why don't you go and introduce the people you have up here on stage with you today?
Well, Marty, you mentioned all the gentlemen you met out in the street, but we also have to...
I didn't say
Johnson,
that, did I?
I'm out on the street as well.
I'm sorry.
Brian Ogihara on Bazooki.
Brian over here. Hey, Brian, come on. Hey. Japanese Irish.
That's right. And the fabulous Steve Pribble on Irish flute.
Steve over in the back.
The Mondo Dave Sawyers on electric bass.
Dave, how you doing? Thank you so much. Tell us a little bit about Irish music. What people don't normally know about folk music. What's it all about?
Well, a lot of this music originated in Ireland.
Wow.
Not only Ireland, but Scotland, England, Wales, even some in Spain and France.
Do you always wear a dress by the chance, well, John? I mean, what's underneath that kilt? Oh, I want to know.
People have always asked that question.
It's not a dress.
It's not a dress?
It's not a dress. And they ask me, you know, what I wear underneath this kilt, and I always think to say that it's a fine pair of hand-knit wool socks.
Stick with the guitar, John. Tell us a little about the CD you just had come out.
Well, we just released that CD a few weeks ago. We have it in a couple record stores. It can be found at the Virgin Megastore on Sunset, in Rhino Records, and Borders on the Promenade in Santa Monica.
What kind of gigs do you have coming up?
Well, we're playing at everyone's favorite, Molly Malone's on May 11th, Saturday evening, and then again Sunday afternoon at Borders on Sunset.
What's your number real quick?
Not Borders on Sunset.
It's not Borders on Sunset?
No, it's not Borders on Sunset.
What is it?
Everyone's favorite.
It's everyone's favorite, though. Borders on the 3rd Street Promenade in Santa Monica.
I'm sure if they come down, they'll hear the music and come just running into the place. What's your phone number real quick if people want to get a hold of you?
Well, you can get a hold of us, and you can get yourselves a CD at 310-587-8237.
You can do one more song for us. What song would that be?
This is a whole set of instrumentals with a song in the middle, which is what we do a lot with our arrangements.
Sure.
And it starts off with Cape Clear.
Okay, let me get out of the way, ladies and gentlemen. Crackmore, one more time. Crackmore, ladies and gentlemen. Last segment of Marty's Corner, we like to go ahead and do something we do every month here in Marty's Corner, which is read off the calendar events to let you people here in the audience and also at home know what's going on in the community. Leanne, why don't you go ahead and start off first?
The Homework Center has opened in Baldwin Park Library, and it's ready to help school-age children with their assignments after school. For specific dates and times, call 818-962-6947.
Now playing at the Covina Valley Playhouse, To Kill a Mockingbird. Tickets are still available through April 28th. Please call 818-339-5134 and reserve your seat today. Leanne?
Join the 10th annual 5K Walk for Wings at the Industry Hills Equestrian Center on Saturday, April 27th. That's next Saturday. Proceeds will benefit Southern California Shelters for Battered Women and Children. And to sign up to walk, call 909-865-2971.
Thank you. Am I here also?
They're just changing us.
Okay. The Santa Anita Park Racetrack announces its new season opening for Big Hoss, the award-winning saloon and dance hall. It features live bands, barbecue specials, and dancing under the stars. For reservations, please call 818-574-1036. And that about does it here for another edition of Marty's Corner. Join us again on Marty's Corner on May 18th as we come to you live from Studio One. Do you want to say anything before we get out of here?
Thank you to our wonderful live studio audience. Oh, yay! Yay!
Again, thank you on behalf of everybody here at Marty's Corner. See us next month. Take care. God bless. Marty's Corner. Goodbye, gentlemen. Goodbye.